root systems are something that we don't necessarily think about when we're working with construction, I think, in general. I think we tend as humans, if we don't see it, it's as if it doesn't exist. And because we don't see roots, we don't really think about them. We think about the canopy, we're looking up at that, we're trying not to damage that, but we're not thinking about what's going on underground. And that's a huge part of the tree system. That's a critical part of the tree system. And that's a part that often gets disrupted, detrimentally so, in construction projects. So we're gonna look at several different things that you can do to avoid damaging root systems in particular. A little bit about not damaging trunks, but we're primarily gonna be talking about what you can do to protect this root system from compaction of vehicles, from trenching damage, from it being used as a storage site for heavy materials, things like that. We're gonna start over here. If you can look over my shoulder, you're gonna see what looks like a balance beam. And that's actually, again, not to spec, it's a demonstration to show you if you were adding, say you're adding a deck onto your house or a decorative hardscape that was gonna have a wall, instead of trenching across those roots, you can see you're very close to the trunk of this tree. Research has proven out that once we get inside 3 times the diameter of a tree, which on this tree is roughly 40 inches, once we start cutting roots, we can affect a tree's stability. Now, a lot of different things go into that, so I'm saying that as a generality, but we want to try to stay outside of that zone when we're damaging root systems. So instead of trenching to build a foundation for something, an option is to drop posts and then build a support beam. So instead of trenching, building a foundation, lift that up and let the weight of what is being built out, whether it's a deck, a wall, let that weight be put on that support beam instead of cutting through the root system. A lot of different options, a lot of municipalities do a lot of work doing this sort of thing. Another thing is when you start having the equipment that comes in. You'll see what's called a tree protection zone set up around trees. And we just have a couple of different options that are things that you would typically see out on a construction site. You see that orange fencing? That's better than nothing, but it's not ideal. It's really easy to cut through that for one thing, or to step over it if you have longer legs than I do. It's not very stable. Very easy for somebody to take down. It's not much of a barrier, honestly. So that's something to factor in as well. Not just the distance from the tree, but what you're actually using to protect that area. So better than nothing, but not great. And then we've got what is like sort of makes me think of like snow fencing or drift fencing that you would see in areas of the world, not like this one, where you would actually have snow. That gives a little more protection, would be a little more difficult to get through. Still not the greatest choice. And then you have just fencing like you could pick up at a local farmer supply store. Again, fairly easy to get through that. Is it better than nothing? Sure, but it still leaves the site pretty accessible. And these are all set up at a minimum distance. These three are all set up at the minimum distance you would want to be if we were doing construction around this oak that I'm standing under. What we would recommend, if you are able to do it, is put up chain link fencing. And if you can see back behind that orange fencing, it's about 10 feet beyond. So that's about 34, 35 feet out from the trunk of this oak. It's basically out to the drip line. And that's a very good gauge to use. If you go out to the drip line, and when I say drip line, I mean the very edge of the canopy. That's called the drip line when it rains and the water comes down. And it's coming off the branches at the end, the leaves at the end, is the drip line. So if you can go all the way out to the drip line, that is an arborist's dream, is to be able to preserve that space. You can rent that fencing, you can purchase it, but you can rent that fencing and have it put up. You can actually have gates put on that that you can lock, and only the supervising arborist with the project, the construction manager, only designated people would have keys. So it makes the area completely inaccessible. What happens on so many construction sites is that you'll put up fencing, but then trucks come in. Or this is a nice shady area, so let's put all the supplies here. So when we're going to load up, we're in the shade. and lots of damage is incurred. That's another easy thing to do if you're not able to put up fencing like we're talking about at the proper depth, and you know that the area is going to be used as a staging area. There are things that you can inquire about. Really thick layers of mulch, not mulch like not the 2 or 3 inches that we've talked about before that would be appropriate for planting. We're talking substantial amounts of mulch that you can put in will help absorb the weight of the materials that are being stored there, the trucks that are driving across. There are also mats that companies use that they can actually put on the ground that the trucks can drive over, over instead of driving on the ground, that help dissipate the weight of the vehicles. So there are lots of different things that you can do on a site, but the biggest part of this comes in the planning before ground is ever broken, like I said. If you have a tree on your property that you're going to be developing, the first thing you need to do is seek a professional arborist, a certified arborist who can come out and help you determine, is it worth all of the expense, and is it a valuable tree that health-wise, species-wise, worth saving, which sounds bad, but it's true. That's your first step. And then really be engaged in that process of asking what you can be doing, what things can be done to help really protect that tree and preserve it so it can continue being a huge part of the environment and ecosystem that you're living in.